sermon, which microphone will be on?
You, if you're at the lectern, you can use that one.
I would.
Yeah, that one's on all the time. So.
Okay. Looks like this is it. Here we are. I'm gonna turn my turned on here. Okay, all these cords here. Okay. Are we on? We are. Good morning. Welcome to all of you on this Sunday morning as we gather for this service on this Memorial Day weekend. Good to see all of you. I'm Dennis Morreim. I will be your worship leader this morning. And right after the worship service here, unfortunately, because I enjoy the people across the street, of course, but I will be going across the street to meet worship there as well. So I won't be able to spend a lot of time with you this morning afterwards. I want to say thank you to you for allowing last Sunday your pastor to come across the street to the Presbyterians, because as some of you may know, I came down with COVID last Saturday, and I'm done with that. I'm still maybe not 100% on my energy. It takes a while to get back, but I feel very well and grateful to be here this morning. We begin by turning to an opening hymn, very powerful hymn, Lift High the Cross, number 660. Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia.
In the waters of baptism, we have passed over from death to life as saving mystery, and for this water, let us bless God, who was, who is, and who is to come. We thank you, O God, for your river of life, flowing freely from your throne, through the earth, through the city, through every living thing. You rescued Noah and his family from the flood. You opened wide the sea for the Israelites. Now in these waters, you flood us with mercy, and our sin is drowned forever. You open the gate of righteousness, and we pass safely through. You nourish us and enclose us in safety. You call us forth and send us out. In lush and barren places, you are with us. You will become our salvation. Now breathe upon this water and awaken your church once more. Claim us again as your beloved and holy people. Quench our thirst. Cleanse our hearts. Wipe away every tear. To you, our beginning and our end, our shepherd and lamb, the honor, glory, praise, and thanksgiving, now and forever.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let's pray. O God, form the minds of your faithful people into your one will. Make us love what you command and desire what you promise, that amid all the changes of this world, our hearts may be fixed where the true joy is found. Your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Please be seated. And our reader.
Good morning.
Good morning.
A reading from Revelations chapter 22, verses 12 through 14, 16 through 17, and 20 to 21. See, I am coming soon. My reward is with me, to repay according to everyone's work. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last, beginning and the end. Blessed are those who wash their robes so that they will have the right to the tree of life and may enter the city by the gates. It is I, Jesus, who sent my angel to you with this testimony for the churches. I am the root and the descendant of David, the bright morning star. The Spirit and the Bride say, come, and let everyone who hears say, come, and let everyone who is thirsty come. Let anyone who wishes take the water of life as a gift. The one who testifies to these things says, surely I am coming soon. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. The grace of the Lord Jesus be with all the saints. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our psalm today is Psalm 97. We'll read responsibly by whole verse. The Lord reigns, let the earth rejoice, let the multitude of the isles be glad.
Clouds and darkness surround the Lord, righteousness and justice are the foundation of God's throne.
Fire goes before the Lord, burning up enemies on every side.
Lightnings light up the world, the earth, seas, and skies.
The mountains melt like wax before the Lord of all the earth.
The heavens declare your righteousness, O Lord, and all the people see your glory.
Confounded be all who worship, crave images, and delight in false gods. Bow down before the Lord, all you gods.
Zion hears and is glad. And the saints of Judea rejoice because of your judgments, O Lord.
For you are the Lord. Most high over all the earth, you are exalted far above all gods.
You who love the Lord, hate evil. God guards the lives of the saints and rescues them from the hand of the wicked.
Light dawns for the righteous and joy for the honest of heart.
Rejoice to the Lord, you righteous, and give thanks to God's holy name.
Please rise if you're able for the reading of the gospel.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus prayed, I ask not only on behalf of these, but also on behalf of those who will believe in me through their word, that they may all be one. As you, Father, are in me, and I am in you, may they also be in us, so that the world may believe that you have sent me. The glory that you have given me, I have given them, so that they may be one as we are one, I in them and you in me, that they may become completely one, so that the world may know that you have sent me and you have loved them even as you have loved me. Father, I desire that those also whom you have given me may be with me where I am to see my glory, which you have given me because you loved me before the foundation of the world. Righteous Father, the world does not know you, but I know you, and you know that you have sent me. I am your name known to them, and I will make it known, so that the love with which you have loved me may be in them, and I in them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Let us pray. O gracious God, gracious God, you are very aware of all of the thoughts and emotions across our country. And we pray, Lord, as your people, as your disciples, help us, Lord, to reflect your love, to reflect your will. We ask all this in your name. Amen. Are you doing okay with me in here? How are we doing back there? All right. Okay, good. Well, this has been a tough week. The tragedy that took place in Uvalde, Texas, has kind of overshadowed all of the other concerns that we, as people across this country, have been revolving around in these previous weeks. Emotions have run high, as we all are aware. And those topics such as abortion and transgender kids and racism, all of those are very familiar to all of us. I'm not going to make this into some kind of a political sermon. That's not my intent. But it is my hope and my prayer that the words that Jesus speaks to us today speak to the concerns we have, not only as individuals, but also as Christians in today's world and in this country. The goal of every preacher is to try to make the passage for the Sunday
The scripture readings that congregation hears relevant to what is going on in the world around them. In this passage, Jesus is in his closing hours with his disciples. They are in the upper room, where they have celebrated together a last meal. And before they leave that upper room, before they go to the Garden of Gethsemane, before Jesus is arrested, Jesus prays for his disciples. You know, it is always comforting to me, it is always humbling to me, when somebody says to me, "I'm praying for you," and it's said in a tone that's not like "I'm praying to get your head screwed on so you see things like I do," not like that at all, but it's said in the tone that "I pray God guide me, God comfort me, God heal you, God affirm you." I remember seeing a woman in the hospital some years ago, and I was a chaplain in the hospital. And she was going in for surgery. And the only thing I knew about her was her name. I knew nothing else about her. And she did not know anything about me except I introduced myself to her as the check. And after a couple of sentences of talking with each other, I asked her, may I have a prayer with you? To which she quietly said, "Yes." And I had a prayer. And when I was finished with the prayer, I noticed that she wiped a tear away from her eye. And then she said, rather with a low voice, she said, "No one has ever prayed for me before." And I felt a sadness about that. And here is a child of God for whom no one had ever said, to her knowledge, said a prayer. You realize here Jesus is not just simply saying a prayer, praying a prayer for the disciples in the room. He is praying a prayer for you and for me and for all of the followers of Christ throughout the centuries. "I pray," he says, "that they may be one as you and I, Father, are one." And he was not only praying that we have that closeness to God, that bond with God, like Jesus had with his Heavenly Father, which is deeper than a father and a child or mother and a child, but that also Jesus prays that we sense a oneness with other Christians around us. And we're not just simply talking about Christians in our Lutheran camp or our Presbyterian camp, but across the board. In today's very, very fragmented church, where we have all of these denominations, all of these synods, all of these conferences, all of these sects of various Christians, that we realize is no small task that he is praying for. Now, I will be the very first to admit that I don't always sense a oneness with all Christians. And I say that because there are times that I have sensed from some groups of Christians that there's an air of superiority, that I'm more religious than you. I'm more spiritual than you. I am more Christ-like than you. And for that reason, I need to take a look at my own attitude toward other people, other Christian people. I'm told, I've read, and I've heard speakers say, that in the very early church, very back in the very beginning of the first century, those on the outside of the Christian church made a comment that said, look at how those Christians love one another. Look at how they love one another. I think of that Bible camp song that when I would take kids to camp and then we would sing with great gusto this song, they will know we are Christians by our love, by our love. Yes, they'll know we are Christians by our love. And, you know, I wish that song were in all of our hymn books to remind us of who we are. I wonder if those same observers way back then, what they would say as they watched Christians today. Particularly when we as a Christian community across the country are divided into the social issues that we grapple with. Grapple is a mild word. Abortion, sexuality, racism, now guns. We see people, you know, screaming in each other's faces, trying to demonize each other because they don't agree with us. And I'm sure if we ask the question, are any of you members of a church? There'd be people on both sides of every issue that say, yes, we are. And that doesn't mean that we should not be passionate about our concerns or the issues of today, or refrain from speaking up. Jesus spoke up when he saw the money changers in the temple. He spoke up about the hypocrisy that he saw in the Pharisees. But that which he never forgot to whom was his highest allegiance. And that highest allegiance was God as Heavenly Father. And so as we ourselves get caught up in some of the issues today, we always need to be asking ourselves, to whom is my highest allegiance? And if it is not to Christ, then what is it? Or who is it? That doesn't mean that we'll never find each other on different sides of an issue, because that can so easily happen. But the question is, how do we treat each other with whom we may disagree? Do we continue to see that person as a brother or sister in Christ? Or does that person suddenly become our enemy? And we need to try to destroy that person by the words we say to their face or behind their back. I ran across a story this past week that I thought was a story that appropriate for the passage today. It's a child's story. It goes way back to the Arabian Nights. And it was believed, or it was said, that there was a rock in the Indian Ocean, a magnetic rock, that was so strong that if a ship passed too close to that rock, it literally pulled out the nails and the bolts that were holding that hull together, and that ship eventually just came apart and sank into the ocean. when our passions or our point of view become so strong that they pull out from our very soul those qualities Jesus instills in us of love, acceptance, understanding, patience. When we lose sight of those, when we lose those, we become simply a shell of who God calls us to be. And our life sinks into the abyss of anger and resentment. Jesus is praying here for you and for me. And he concludes this prayer with the words, I have made you known to them in order that the love you have for me may be in them. That the love you have for me may be in them. They will know we are Christians by our love. Yes, they will know we are Christians by our love. May that always, regardless of how wrapped up we may get in the issues of the day, may we never ever lose sight of that. That we are Christ's disciples, known by our love. Amen. community of believers, let us rise and affirm together that which we believe in the Apostles' Creed. I believe
in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead.
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church,
the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Captivity to sin and death. We pray to the God of the resurrection, for the church, for people in need, and for all creation. Holy God, make your people one as you and your Son are one. Extend the gifts we have been given by your Spirit to all people, especially those experiencing division or questioning your love. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Make worthy the work of scientists who look to the stars and planets, as well to scientists who look to atoms and molecules. Bring innovation and well-being to humanity through their discoveries. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Keep in our minds those who died in war, both military and civilians. Especially we think of today all those in the country Ukraine. Be with those families, those individuals, those who are wounded, those who are refugees, those who have become prisoners of war, those who grieve the loss of loved ones. Give them your comfort and your strength. May we honor them by seeking peaceful solutions to the conflicts that arise among nations and peoples. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Grant freedom to all who are overwhelmed by chronic illness, depression, or constant worry, especially those whom we name in our hearts at this time. We pray, Lord, especially all for all those who grieve the loss of loved ones in the small town of Uvalde, Texas. We pray, Lord, help us as a country and guide us as a country. Lord, in your mercy, unite us with the saints who have died and been raised in Christ. Train us to walk with eager longing for Christ to come again, even as we sense his presence with us now. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Thank you also, Lord, on this Memorial Day weekend, for all those who have served in our militaries, those men and women who have put forth their lives in service to their country. We pray especially for those families
who grieved the loss of loved ones, who gave their ultimate sacrifice for defending their country. Lord, in your mercy, in your mercy, O God, respond to these prayers we pray, and renew us by your life-giving Spirit, through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. As you are comfortable in so doing, please share the peace with those around you.
Done on earth as it is in heaven.
our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
You may be seated, and simply follow the directions of those who are will be distributing the bread and the wine. I'm going to be extra cautious for all of you.
To the hungry.
Crucified and risen Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, has just bestowed upon you his holy body and blood, and thereby he has forgiven you all of your sins. May he strengthen and preserve us in the true faith unto life that is everlasting. Amen.
Amen.
We pray together. We give you thanks, gracious God, for this bread and cup. We have tasted the new heaven and earth. For hunger and thirst are no more. Send us from this table as witnesses to the resurrection, that through our lives all may know life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious upon you. May the Lord look upon all of us with favor and give unto all of us his everlasting peace. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Save your forever. He sought me.
Hallelujah, Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Go in peace. Tell what God has done.
Thanks be.